episode of Finno-Greek Machining, we are going to make steel ring around that rubber boot of the gear, so that it doesn't flex sideways. Well, that's the only thing. Well, not the only thing. We are also going to glue it on place. But yeah, there is still something to do with that one. So yeah, so let's start with this ring. I am going to need a 20 millimeter wide band from this steel plate. Well, the steel plate is 2 millimeters thick, and the band, the resulting band, shouldn't have any holes in it. So the first task is to get rid of the holes. Now, cutting off the actual band. As you can see, there are two hand vices holding a ruler, which I'm using to keep the cut straight. The blade in the jigsaw, that's carbide blade. Here I'm removing most of the paint and sharp edges with my orbital sander. Here I'm now bending this into a ring. I don't have the roller thing, so I have to do this just like this manually. That's how it will be installed into place. So I'm making now here two bushings. This is 12 millimeters in diameter, and they will be 35 millimeters long, and there will be a 6 millimeter hole through. Pretty simple. Well, yeah. First facing. The surface finish is horrific. Oh man. Let's try a better one. Hopefully this helps. This is mild steel, so... that way, that way. I'm just figuring out which other way. That way. Take care of the edge. Okay, that's okay. Almost down. And I don't want to use this tool. Well, this tool I might use. But, well, I always file this nibble away. It's easier. And it's not... It's actually faster than doing this with a tool. Okay. Accepted. But not for long. Okay. That should be done. Then we need this kind of a drill, stubby. This is a 10 millimeter stubby drill. I only use the tip of that for drilling this. There you go. Oh, it's too far away. Not too far, but okay. Just try here. That's all it is. This is quite soft, actually. Really soft. And I think for drilling 6 millimeters that speed for that kind of material, which is really soft, it's okay. Now I just drill this through. Very, 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 very simple thing to do. Let's see. Smokes a little bit. Not good. Shouldn't. Too much anyway. Maybe we have a little bit too much speed. Lucky us, we can lower it down. Okay. Push my luck with this one. You can grab the drill inside there, and the workpiece is not very valuable in this case, but the drill is. It's a good quality drill, and if I break it, so then I need a new. Feel how it becomes crunchy. There is a very good feedback in this weight of telescope, so you can feel when it starts to be not very lubricated, so to say. Okay, now I actually deburred these ends. They are now okay. Oh. And now the next step is to make a groove into here. This is 2 millimeter wide slitting saw, and the depth will be 2 millimeters. We are still having here. We should have 1 millimeter left to the wall, but well. Let's see. I'm running this at 90 revolutions per minute, and I'm going to run this dry because this is going to be silver soldered, and I don't want to have any oil now here. So let's see how this goes. Feeding manually, really. I don't want to. This goes really easy. This is no resistance, and that's good. Oh, a little bit resonates. Okay. Then let's Seventeen revolutions per. A lot better. Now milling a flat to this workpiece. This is to create a clearance for the gear. it fits there, but just barely. So it's better to have it a little bit bigger, this clearance, than something like 0.1 millimeters. And yeah, this should be run a little bit faster. So now it's 340 revolutions per minute. Let's see. And the depth of this is 1 millimeter. And again, I'm feeding by hand. Preparing these two and that one for silver soldering these on place. Well, yeah. So I'm using the black stuff here. Let's see whether it is. Oh yeah, it's black. Really black. So I just put some of this into the grooves here. You really don't need a lot in this case. Just enough to protect the surface while it's warming up. And then this one as well. Okay, maybe there you are. And now these two, this is the flat, it goes inside the ring here, And this should be a little bit tight. And it is. We need this stuff there. And well, about that much. And this is a little bit horrific because it tries to fly across the room when you cut it. So therefore I have a rag here which takes care of the flight tendency. That's one. And then another. That is probably too much already, but yeah. Ah. Yeah, there you are. Well, how to do this? Maybe just because now these must be half buried into this this stuff. Really. It's better to do this by finger. And just put it there. There you are. This stuff is water soluble. And yeah. Okay, now you can see it. There is air in the now the air is gone. Now just warm them up. From the back side, so melt any moment. Oh yeah, very cold. Oh yeah, now it's crossing the there. beautiful. Yeah. Now let it cool down. The definite mistake here is to drop into cold water right away. You need to let it cool down to that, so that it becomes black. Okay. Let's start the cleaning process. Well, this should be glued in place. When it's on there. Otherwise it's very difficult to get it correctly. So, therefore, I will first put it there. Now, I will get some grease here on my fingers at least. There you are. A little bit more. There you are. Like that. Okay. And now, let's clean it. There isn't much of grease in that one, but nevertheless, I want to get that. Well, there is some. Maybe this is the rubber that is melting because of this solvent. Well, that's it. The the stuff I'm using is really, really messy in a way. Okay, this is almost clean. Okay, and then I put this, that's that, and then that's that. Here I'm going to inject this stuff, this is Sikaflex, into the gap here. I have adjusted it so that there is a, well, about even gap everywhere. Well, it's not, but about. So, now I just put this there in between and try to inject it into the gap. Yeah, it sure goes there, that's for sure. This is the hardest place here, near. And yeah, my neighbor is washing the roof. And here is also some pointed. Okay, and now comes the soapy finger on play here. So here is my soapy water on the side here, and I just dip my finger there, and then I go around here because this tries to attach to my finger right away if I don't have that soapy water. And the surface finish becomes really nice when you do it like this. And you don't need to take care of all the small details here, because it will eventually... There you are. And now I just let it cure. Well, that's the ring glued in place. Well, it's still curing. It takes something like 1 day at least to cure. And after that, it's not even totally cured. It's somewhat like not cured. So I just let it sit there and do something else while it's curing. Because this has to be let do its thing in peace without disturbing it. Then it becomes really solid and whatever. So in the next episode of fenugreek machining, it might not probably be that one. It might be something else, something small. Well, I figure it out, of course. But till then, bye!